Side effect of fucking random mode. Vines glitch out with inverted controls. We have that fixed in Culture 2, but we never fixed it in Culture 1. Because not a lot of thought was went into it. That's shocking, I know. I'll probably be able to get back there a lot quicker, though, since I got fucking spotlight for half the fucking rooms. This is all ice mode now. It's the ice meta. Oh my god. Oh! That's so nice of you! That's so nice of you! Just... yeah. Oh, you wanna restart. That's cool. We'll just give you all the same shit all over again. Thanks. And fuck you. Ah! This time with extra spotlight! Spotlight for life. Ah, dude, I'm so scared. I was telling Ira today, I'm like, dude, when people start stealing my Tyrion, I'm gonna fucking cry. Like, I'm genuinely gonna fucking weep. When some, like, molester priest steals my fucking legendary. And I don't even get the death rattle from it. Like, the worst part. I think that card is gonna see a lot of play. I know some people are like, eh, it might be too slow. Yeah. Dude, my balls are too slow. You're gonna see that card. Like, dude, it doesn't matter. Priests are like... they're so durable. Like, you know, like... nobody kills a priest quickly because they heal. I mean, it happens, but like... A priest can afford to have a slow card that's that strong. That's gonna be some shit. Well, I mean, like, dude. Like, what a great way to get the Tyrion off the table. Like, my god. Like, no death rattle, no divine shield, just beep boop, right into my deck. And then you gotta deal with them at a later date. That's like my worst nightmare. Like, alright, you silence my Tyrion, alright, I mean, whatever. You steal him. Now I'm mad. Believe it or not, this is actually better than inverted controls.
Why is this another shit. Child? I wanna be the pickle. Suck my
Fuck, how do I
wiener
unsplit?
shit face. No.
I gotta unsplit it. I'll let the clock run for like a little bit, then I'll unsplit it to balance it out. How do you do this? I just did this the other day. There we go. Let's go. Why does meteors even exist in that room? Really gotta start hotkeying after how often I fat finger it. Wow, this is stupid. G dream now. That's such a refreshing RNG instead of getting spotlight all the time. Speak of the devil. Spotlight show up. Best to not say its name. Sentient fan game knows your worst fear and gives it to you. Shit. There's a giant skip here with that. I think with low gravity I can like skip like I can skip the skip, right? Kind of cool. Gotta take these slow though. God, the low G dream. But make do. God damn it. I could just feel it in the bottom of my balls when I walked up to that jump that it was gonna kill me. Yikes. Spotlight. wonder if Culture 2 is going to be this terrible to me. Although, Spotlight shouldn't be as bad. Oh, fuck, I forget where it's at. I think we nerfed it a little. Shit! Why am I so bad at this? Dude! Yeah, I actually didn't get Meteor here. Very observant. That's a rarity. I feel like this room is hard-coded. My god! Why am I dying here? It's not even the speed gimmick that's killing me. It's just, like, bad gameplay. Hey, bro, what's up? Oh shit! It's not really that much faster. It's the illusion of it being faster. Yeah, that Goomba can kill you. Absolutely it can. There's an achievement in this game for getting killed by one of the bosses, any of the bosses, because it's like the ultimate stupidity. Just like my death right there. Yeah, you should get Meteor in here, too. Although choking at the end of this room doesn't really help me much. Ah! Inverted controls. I mean, it saves anyway, so it wouldn't have mattered, but still, it's funny. Because the drop of inverted controls is really awkward. This should actually be easier, and I'm dying more. God. I honestly don't know anything about Herp Derp as a game. This screen was one of the original screens that was put into this game when it was like still a joke game that he gave me. We just left it in, I guess, because we don't have, like, a lot of gravity-flipping screens in this game. And I was like, alright, well. Why not? There's a lot more gravity-flipping in the sequel. sorry if you don't like that gimmick. This is the Croatian Rhapsody. It's like one of the most frequently asked questions. Try. Just have a horseshoe up my ass today. Croatian Rhapsody? How do I spell it? Actually jump where the platform is. Dumbass, you should know, since it's your game. In the README file to this game is like all of the music is like documented with download links, I think. Really like the soundtrack to this game, then just download it and then you can go find everything. A lot of people really like the music in this game. Piece of cheese is a good taste. Nicely here. I'm not trying to be a dick. I just genuinely want to get out of this room. Please let me out. README file guy. We actually have a guy who, like, that's his job is the README file and making sure all that stuff is well documented. Flagelstand, if you see him around. He's doing the same thing with the sequel. Very useful. For small. Oh my god. Inverted controls on vines, please. Please. Ice doesn't work in this room, so it's kind of free. Yo, what's up, dude? How's it going? I almost always get spotlighted in this room, and it's a major, major time waste. Sandbox Magician! Thank you so much, dude. 14 months. Keeping it alive. Keeping the dream alive and the lamp on. Alright, the next room is like probably the single most important one in the game. Fucking rip. Fucking rip. We shall overcome. I feel like my luck so far has been pretty good.
You can do it.
Zurai says I can do it, so I feel like if I can do it and Zurai's right, then this might be salvageable. I don't know though. Like, the only saving grace is that I just did this whole game in Spotlight, like, a couple days ago. Let's see how much of this I can remember. Training for this moment. A moment when you find out what you're really made of. Bullshit right now. Like, I'm actually, like, handling this pretty well so far. Like, this is an incredibly, incredibly bad situation. This is literally the worst case scenario for running this game on this mode, is this exact thing. And I don't know. That's the hardest jump in the whole thing, right there. It's like a very, very far, very blind jump. Oh my god, who's calling me? I can't deal with that right now. Jesus. Oh my god, I can't focus with the fucking phone. It is my mom. You're right. I already know what she's gonna want. She doesn't want anything. I have a dinner there at her house on Sunday for my birthday. And she's just gonna call me and tell me what she's making. And I'm gonna be like, okay. Now, if I get spotlight on the next screen as well, which is coming up here, then we're probably cooked. It's probably over, like, at that moment, instantly. Continuing the run would probably be completely pointless. Not as bad. It's a gate jump. Please. Why can I not do the gate underwater with speed? This in spotlight is terrible, by the way. Please. Fucking please. Fuck me. Don't you fuck me. Fucking meteors. I have no idea if I'm ahead or behind. on my PB. Part of me doesn't want to know. Because if I know, I'm going to start playing like shit. I'll get mad. I'm behind. Oh, bullshit. Creator, more of the director. I pick the rooms and the games. Piece of cheese, pick the music and all the coding. About the music, yeah, he's got good taste in music. Fuck that. The sequel to this is like even better. It's like a lot better. Oh my god, I can't see. Stop with the spotlights. Gotta be shitting me right there. I'm gonna freak out. I'm gonna freak out. Haven't even played the new games of the day, but there's not really any. There's like one. I'll say one and a half, because there's something somebody gave me as a demo to try. Why did I do that? Like, never go that way. Dude! This is a giant, like, waste of time. Of course it had to be bouncing at that exact vector, at that exact moment. Like the only trajectory that would have led to a death. Jesus, lost a lot of time in there. You gotta be fucking kidding me. Nothing but fucking spotlights. That's why doing like random mode runs of this is such a stamina test. It's like mentally exhausting dealing with like the ridiculousness of how often Spotlight comes up. Even though I've seen the code. The code is no way biased to give you Spotlight more than anything else. It's just a confirmation bias. It's just, you just notice it more. What did I get? Gravity. Now this is like some bullshit. At this point, I'm, like, gonna call shenanigans. Like, why is it always fucking Spotlight? And now I've gotta do, like, the worst jump in the stage blind. This jump at the end of this room is terrible. And doing it blind is going to be even more terrible. Yeah, there's like no way. God forbid we do it first try. my god. Solaris. Dude, come on. Dude, come on. There's a lot of spots in this room that you can die to. Like, that shouldn't be one of them. What? This is like one of the worst rooms in the fucking stage. Nah, this is the worst room in the stage, honestly. What's up, Cookie? Ah! This is really obnoxious with inverted controls. Have I met the creator of I Wanna Be the Guy? No. I'm okay with that. I don't really have anything to say to him. Oh my god! Dude, fucking shit! My brain is still with inverted controls because I just was doing it for the last two rooms. Believe me, there's been enough thinking back at that game. Too much. People not need to stop thinking back and start looking forward. People still cling to things from that game that are terrible. Yeah, plus he doesn't really have a high opinion of fan games. Although, granted, the last time he probably paid attention to fan games. probably wasn't much to have a good opinion of. Do that. Yeah, he's very out of touch. And that's okay. It's just it's more on the game makers now to stop imitating the original, because large parts of the original are terrible. It's basically a booby trap game with like half-ass platforming and campy boss fights. Good thing about random mode is that if you screw a skip up, it doesn't matter. That's right. He did what we needed him to do. He fulfilled his destiny. Take it from here. Jesus Christ. Yeah, people like you still use like the brown blocks and the Guilty Gear music and the restarting music and all the idiotic traps. I mean, there's nothing wrong with traps. Traps are always be a part of fan games, but there's stupid traps, and then there's creative traps. And if you haven't seen some of the trap games that people have made, you don't understand just how creative some traps can really be, and how interesting and funny they are. The days of just, like, a spike shooting off the wall, though, should be over. We should be, like, well beyond that now. Time to go forward. Jesus. This is one of the nastier rooms in the game. This is not fun with ice. Good news about ice on this, though, is you can see the floor. The bad news is the platforming is ass. Why do I always get spotlight in this room? Dude, what have I done to deserve this? Like, seriously. Why have I been forsaken? With the fucking eternal spotlight. This room is actually a disadvantage. Turn it into an advantage though, I guess. Low G makes downward diagonal jumps much more difficult to do. If you ever tried to do a downward diagonal in water, it's harder. Oh boy. This is gonna be amazing. Merciful Jesus. This is probably the worst case scenario in here. Even spotlight in this room is not that bad because all the jumps are like in close proximity to each other. You can like see, you can like always see the next jump pretty much with spotlight on. Speed makes this. Oh my god! Really aggravating. Wow! Really? Fucking really, dude? is like the worst fucking run of this game ever. You can't even think up RNG worse than this. Like, if you gave me a chart and told me to write in the worst gimmick for every room, this is what it would look like. Oh my god. I mean, that's the worst part about it, is I gotta deal with this for fucking two screens. Like, dude, everything this run is just so bad. I have no idea how my time is. My time may actually be okay despite this. I'm really overcoming the fucking worst of the worst with this game right now. Oh my god! What the fuck, bro? What the fuck? Fuck you. How many? Way too many spotlights. Way too many. Pretty much all you need to know. If you get spotlight in the tower, it's one too many. Which I did. I actually handled that tower pretty well, considering the circumstances. Jeez, I gotta land in that little gap with the fucking ice. That's like fucking torture. Oh! That's fucking wonderful! Fuck you in the asshole! It's not like there's a blind drop or anything on this with zigzagging, toggling fucking spikes. No, there's nothing like that in this room. I gotta aiming for the wrong fucking spike. Ah! Why does this game hate the creator so much? This is, you gotta be shitting me. This is what you wanted, Bisnap. This is what you wanted. You were like, I want some of this. You're getting it. You're getting it, dude. Oh my god! I don't think I've ever died to that, ever. Okay, assholes. They even gave me spotlight in the fucking portal room. When inverted controls wears off, my brain's gonna still be wired the wrong way. This is like a long room. It's really awkward. I don't know what my problem. That's the water in the inverse controls. It feels weird. Thank you. You fucking asshole! Oh my god. It's pretty much over at this point. Like, the run is fucking over. Might as well just turn it off. It's not just Spotlight again. It's, which in itself is ludicrous, because I've gotten it like 100 fucking times. It's the fact that it's Spotlight on another blind tower jump room. If there's fucking 3 rooms in this game you don't want to get Spotlight on, it's Gay Tower 1, Gay Tower 2, and fucking this room. And I've gotten it in Gay Tower 1 in this room. It's like... getting a PB is virtually impossible now. I mean, it might have been impossible before, I don't even know. It's like, I think it's like, is it 2 hours or 2.5 hours? I don't even know. Yeah, let's just not focus on it. I'm gonna try my best to play this run out to the fucking bitter conclusion. Because I don't have anything else to do today. Again, if I hadn't recently, and I mean like very recently, played this whole game in Spotlight mode, this would be going like infinitely more painful than it is right now. I still remember like traces of the Spotlight run. This is like the hardest segment right here. Got like 2 really bad blind jumps in it. That's 1. Fucking save. My god, I did the same thing last time. kind of. Maybe it's possible. It's just gonna depend on what I get. Maybe I can still salvage this. I need like a really good rest of the game though. Fuck! It's like last jump in the fucking in the stage right there. But still, speed's like one of the hardest gimmicks overall. Like the hardest segment in the stage here. After this one, kind of home free, but this is a very unpleasant segment. He removed a save point here. Do that. Low G in here is both a blessing and a curse. It's good in the sense that there's a lot of drops and stuff, and a lot of F jumps that are very extended. But it's bad that there's also a lot of diagonal stuff you have to do. The hardest jump in the room is a diagonal, upside down. Low gravity compounds that difficulty. But if, would I rather have this or spotlight? Yeah, I'll take this. Sure. That's one of them. This could negate the fucking spotlight tower. In terms of them throwing me a bone. I gotta reset it. There we go. You always have to, like, press R when you hit that save to synchronize the platforms to the next. Oh, I can skip. There's a nice skip here, actually. That's a fantastic skip. It's a shitty segment to not have to do. The other potentially, well, this is the segment that this whole makes this room so fucking annoying. I've got to do two downward diagonals with low gravity, and one of them is upside down, which is really problematic. The upside down one in particular is like the devil. Well, in a lot of rooms, low gravity is the best because it allows you to do some crazy skips in certain rooms. I mean, for the majority of the game, low gravity is best. I think if you look at my times on the charts, if I have a time for each mode of this game, if I had to guess offhand, I would say that the low gravity time is probably the fastest of the gimmick runs that I've done. Although probably still not, I don't know if it's faster than my normal mode run, probably not. Some people might find surprising. You can, like, save a ton of time in the towers with it. But in, like, other rooms, it's not really helping you. Like, in a segment like this, it doesn't do anything for me. I actually have to go slower because I have to be more mindful of my jump heights. Because there's like spikes on the ceiling everywhere, and jumping too high is going to get you killed. Yeah, why don't you be a pal? And stop requesting me to put my fucking dick in a salad shooter. Low gravity is a nice warm place to put it. Oh, for fuck's sake! That was just a fucking good old-fashioned choke. The kind that only I can deliver. Oh, that's bad. That's bad. I'm not in control right now. Oh my god! I'm just throwing it. Just fucking throwing this shit away. It's better than permanence, too. Permanence, too, is really unforgiving because of the avoidances. If those avoidances weren't permanence, too, I would run it, like, all the time. Especially that first one. Is this a low gravity boss?
Hello, shitface. How are you doing on this mighty fine day? The weather sure is great. You know.
Oh my god, did I just die? Wow, I L-stratted out of a death. I can't believe that could kill you. Nothing else in this room kills you, but that fucking Goomba kills you? Since when? The fuck is that?
Well, everybody's heard about the
cheap death. My L-strats. Giza will always get you. He's sneaky like that. This fucking game. Now, obviously the ice is not really cool either. Oh, fuck me. Obviously, the next room, I don't have to say it, is one of the most important rooms in the game for this. A bad pick in the next room is catastrophic. God damn it! Probably like one of the top three or four most important rooms in the game in a random mode run. Next to the towers. Why am I stuck here? The zigzagging back and forth there is really hard on my brain with the controls in burst. What? I would call this... middle of the road, borderline unfortunate. It could be a lot worse than this. But it could be a lot better, too. Ice and low gravity are the shit in here. Because you never touch the floor, so ice doesn't really matter, and low gravity is obvious. Where I could just beast mode the room like it's my fucking job. This segment is probably gonna be the worst. C2 doesn't have L strats, no. In Culture 2, you can hit backspace at any time to exit the room and go back to the stage hub from any room. So, we don't need to have an L in the game. If you ever get stuck, you can just hit backspace and go back. But you shouldn't get stuck anywhere. I don't think anyone's gotten stuck yet playing it. God, that fucking part. And there's also no save jumping. Like you can do in 3200 min. So people are actually gonna have to play the game legit. They want to speedrun it. At least I think they will. I mean, the person who figured out the L strat thing has played the game and is one of our testers. She also has a bigger dick than probably most of us. I forgot about this room. I knew it. I changed my mind in midair about whether I was going to go for it or not. Person wreck at Hearthstone on occasion. She has great boar control. You said my time for this was 2-something? annoying, but not a huge problem. I'd rather have, like, ice in here. Oh, God, I'm still... My brain's still reversed. I'm stuck with this for, like, all three rooms, right? He's gonna fuck me all the way to the end. I don't know. I'd rather have spotlight in here than speed. Speed is, like, the worst. Especially in the next room. Makes this room, like, 1,000 times more difficult. This is not great, but not devastating. This is workable. Skip. Please. Beautiful. Fucking beautiful. How am I this far ahead? It doesn't even make sense. Well, let's worry about beating the game and then we'll figure it out. The credits roll, we'll look at the splits. You can thank Piece of Cheese and his super Microsoft Paint skills for that. Oh, thanks, dude. Thanks for dropping a hot deuce on my fucking head. No, man. Go easy with that shit. Fucking Christ. This fight's actually Oh my god, really? Shooting one back over your shoulder, huh? Are ya? Is that what you're gonna do? To the extent that Biff has shoulders. Fuck me. Dude! So, in random mode, since it saves every time you cycle to a new screen, the Biff fight is a lot easier, because if you die in the room, you just respawn in the room. Of course, it sucks if you get a shitty room, but... Piece of Cheese was working on a final boss for this game. It was gonna be a medley fight. And then... the game maker crashed. And he didn't save after working on it for 6 hours. And he lost it all. He's ready to kill himself. And I said, well, maybe we should make a different final boss. And at the time, Wiki Roulette was kind of a thing. Well, more of a thing. Still a thing, but just not as much. I was like, we could do like a boss kind of based on that. So if you could figure out how to code it. So we kind of came up with the idea, and I was like, can you do that? And he's like, I think so. And then he like coded it and picked the rooms that would show up during the fight, which I hate, but it is what it is. Had it not been for that Game Maker crash, though, Biff would never exist. And this series would lack a villain. So you can blame Game Maker for planting the seed for Biff. Yeah, not today, Spotlight. What do we say to Spotlight? Not today. Fuck! Through the fucking floor. That's like one of my ideal final rooms. I think I've beaten this game more with this room in stage 3 than any other room. Pretty good time. Let's see. Ah! What? How could that be? What? I got spotlight on like on both towers. Imagine if I didn't.